that he was 12 years ago. I'm not the same person I was 12 years ago. You're not the same person you were 12 years ago. And so to try to drag up a porn star who says she had a one-night stand with a billionaire 12 years ago and try to give her a voice of morality in America, that's what I find to be preposterous.
I think she said it was more than once, but I'm listening to you very closely. And again, you know, you've sat with the president on a number of occasions, I mean, in conversations mm-hmm. with him. How does he, you know, come to terms with his faith and his, you called it his businessman past, others have called it a playboy past. How has he explained that to you?
Well, the Apostle Paul, who's been called the greatest example of Christianity, the Christianity ever produced, he was known for, you know, he persecuted the church in his prior life. But in a scripture in the Bible, for 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1, Paul said, I've wronged no man, because he was saying the person that I am now and the person I was then are two different persons. And so the Donald Trump of today, President Trump, is not the same as the Donald Trump from 12 years ago. And so we can't try to make a comparison between the two in the sense of where he is right now.
Joshua, how do you see it?
Brooke, it's just an absolute mess. You know, these are some of the same leaders of my faith. I'm a proud Christian, but some of the same leaders who've been telling us for decades that character matters. But apparently when it comes to Donald Trump, character doesn't matter anymore. There's a major difference between Donald Trump and the Apostle Paul. The Apostle Paul was held up on the road to Damascus and turned around. He went in a different direction. There's nothing about Donald Trump that indicates that he's gone in a different direction. Now, look at the spectacle we just witnessed over the last week. Not just one, but two pornographic actresses, models, have said with great credibility, with more seriousness than Trump has when he addresses these issues, that they had adulterous relationships with Donald Trump when his third wife was either pregnant or parenting their newborn child. That is devastating for the credibility and the Christian witness of those who wrap their arms and the good name of Jesus and God and the Bible around this man. And that's going to have impacts not only on their credibility, but on Christian witness in this country for years, if not decades to come. It's just a mess, Brooke.
No, if these things were happening while in the Oval Office, if these things happened 6 months ago, it would be different. But we don't know when Donald Trump had his personal Damascus experience. You have to understand, as far as evangelicals are concerned, all the major tenets of the Christian faith, Donald Trump embraces wholeheartedly. Pre-existence, virgin birth, sinless life, vicarious death, burial, resurrection, ascension, second coming of Jesus Christ. He believes in all of that. Now, his personal walk with God, his sanctification process, that's between him and God, just like yours is between you and God, and Brooks is between her and God, and everybody else it is. So we can't set a standard and say he has to walk a certain way now. We don't know when his epiphany began, but I will say this. We can see, based on his conduct, at least since the election began, that man got so much prayer by so many different preachers, it would have been amazing that he didn't win. Every time I turned around, Donald Trump was lifting up his hands and bowing and submitting his heart to Jesus Christ as his Lord and requesting prayer. So I can't say that his personal domestic experience, just because it's not the same as yours or anybody else's, you can't say it's not genuine.
He's
at a stage in his Christian walk where, you know, I don't want to bring up something from 12 years ago. Now, give me something from 12 days ago, we might can have a conversation.
How about something from 3 years ago? This is what Donald Trump said in 2015.
Have you ever asked God for forgiveness? That's a tough question. I don't think in terms of, I'm a religious person. Shockingly, because people are so shocked when they find this out.
But have you ever asked God for forgiveness?
I'm not sure I have. I just go and try and do a better job from there. I don't think so. I think if I do something wrong, I think I just try and make it right. I don't bring God into that picture. I don't.
So, Joshua, let me ask you about that, because, you know, in Christianity, a key tenet is forgiveness. But in order to forgive, and let's say one can forgive sins of someone's past, doesn't the person you're forgiving, in this case, we're talking about the president, need to ask for forgiveness, own up to those things?
That's right. And as Pastor Scott knows, and I'm sure teaches, a core tenet of repentance is owning up to it, turning around, going in a different direction. Donald Trump just said on that tape, you played, I don't bring God into this. That was a recent tape. And I think we've got to take this out of the realm of the political and start thinking about this as human beings, as people who are looking after human dignity. If that was your brother-in-law and he was treating your sister the way Donald Trump appears to have treated Melania Trump when she was pregnant or parenting their newborn, is that someone you would trust? If that was the pastor of your church or the principal of your child's school and you found out that there was a strong possibility that they cheated on their third wife with two pornographic actresses, is that someone you would trust to lead? But for some reason, we're endowing this man with our trust, with our presumption that they've turned around, and giving him the authority to lead the greatest country in the world. I just think that's a devastating thing for the credibility of those who support him and for the long-term position of the church in the United States.
Pastor Scott?
I don't necessarily think so, simply because if this happened before they were principal, if this happened before they were the pastor, it would be one story. And if their wife chose to remain with them, it would remain with them. However, I don't look to see how faithful an airplane pilot was before I let him fly the plane. I don't look to see how faithful the bus driver was to his wife before I ride on his bus. There are certain things that remain between a man and God. There are certain things that remain between a man and his wife. And I don't know what thoughts, and you don't know what thoughts, Donald Trump has when he lays his head on that pillow and he's talking to God or talking to his inner self or his conscience is speaking to him just because he's not going to get on television and bare his soul. So you got.
Don't forget to click subscribe. It's almost as satisfying as skip ad.